His first steps to freedom. Sam Hallam has been behind bars for 7 years. He went in a teenager. Today, at 24 years old, he's been released on bail, the prosecution withdrawing any opposition to his appeal. Too emotional to talk this afternoon, his supporters described their surprise at the dramatic turn of events.
I think the word is shock. He's obviously delighted, but he's very dazed because we were hoping for a successful outcome to this appeal, but we weren't expecting it would happen today.
Sam Hallam was 18 when he was jailed for life in 2005. He was found guilty of killing a 21-year-old trainee chef in Islington.
It was here in Old Street the victim was attacked with bats and knives. The prosecution relied on two witnesses identifying Sam Hallam among a gang of up to 40 youths in what was described as a confusing and fast-moving situation. But there was no CCTV evidence or indeed forensic evidence to suggest he was here at the scene.
His supporters say he should never have been brought to court, claiming the Met Police failed to properly investigate his alibi and the evidence was unreliable. The prosecution case had significant inconsistencies and there were concerns about the way the judge summed up the trial.
There is actually a legal duty on the police to pursue what's termed reasonable lines of inquiry. They didn't do it in this case. They didn't do their job. And not only did an innocent man go to prison, the actual perpetrators of this dreadful murder largely escaped justice.
There's been a vigorous campaign to free him. Even last night, a vigil to raise awareness about what they say is a serious miscarriage of justice. This morning, his mother repeated her claim her son was innocent.
There was two people's hearsay, and that is it. And they don't mention my son in their first statement. I just know that he was not there.
Tomorrow at the Court of Appeal, Sam Hallam's conviction is expected to be quashed. His father would have wanted to be there, but he committed suicide 2 years ago, according to his family, due to the stress of his son's case. Guy Smith, BBC News.